The standalone project browser is the main Prism application used to manage all types of projects. There are several ways to access it. One way is to open the project browser using the default Prism shortcut. A second option is to type Prism in the Windows search box and open the application. Option 3 is to open the project browser by clicking the Prism system tray in the taskbar. And a fourth option is to right-click the system tray and select Project Browser from the menu. In addition, the Project Browser can be launched directly from within the DCC integrations. In this case, the Project Browser would be a separate sub-process of the respective integration and could run in parallel to the standalone Project Browser. In order to create assets for a new project, the Prism Project Browser will be used. Right-click in the Assets tab and select Create Asset. Enter a name and specify a thumbnail by right-clicking and selecting Browse or by pasting an image from the clipboard. In addition, a description can be set, a task preset can be loaded, and metadata can be attached. By selecting Create, Prism will build the asset structure in the background, and the robot asset will be visible in the Assets tab. To change the information about the asset, right-click below the asset info and edit the description or change the thumbnail. To keep a clean project, it is recommended to create folders at the very beginning of a project. Right-click in the Assets tab and select Create Folder, set a name and select Create. In this way, characters and props can be organized within different folders. To add departments for the recently created assets, select either a single asset or multiple assets at once by holding down Shift. Right-click in the Departments tab, select Add Department, choose Modeling, and then select Create. Modeling departments for both assets have been created. In addition, multiple departments can be created by holding down Shift during the selection. With the task presets checkbox enabled, all the necessary departments can be created at once. Custom departments can be created by right-clicking in the Departments tab and selecting Add Department. Right-click again into the empty space and select Create New Department. Set a name, an abbreviation, and select Create. A custom department has been created. To add a task to a given department, right-click in the Tasks tab and select Add Task. By default, Prism suggests a modeling task. After selecting Create, the modeling task has been created. After creating the default surfacing task, additional custom tasks can be added. Right-click in the Tasks tab and select Add Task. Set a name and continue with Create. In this way, the texturing and surfacing processes can be separated into individual tasks within the surfacing department. In order to create an initial scene file, right-click in the Files tab of a given task, select Create New Version from Preset, and choose Empty Scene Houdini. Double-click to open the created Houdini scene file. Houdini will load the default scene file, which is visible as well in the integrated Houdini project browser. In case a scene was already opened or created outside the pipeline, open the project browser of the respective DCC, right-click in the Files tab, and select Create New Version from Current. By refreshing the standalone project browser, both scene files are visible.